Thank you for taking the time to review the Renton School District information on HVAC systems and COVID-19 risk minimization. We look forward to welcoming students and staff back to our schools as safely as possible. As we prepare for this, there are many questions about COVID-19's airborne transmission risk and how it can be transmitted by HVAC systems. To respond to these questions, we have put together this presentation in which we will review the following topics: how HVAC systems work in the Renton School District schools and facilities, how the function of these systems relate to COVID-19 and viral transmission in general, and the steps the Renton School District is taking to minimize transmission of COVID-19 from one space to another. First and foremost, it needs to be clearly understood that risk reduction for spreading COVID-19 requires a large effort from everyone involved. Even in laboratory settings where HVAC systems are designed to prevent the spread of pathogens and viruses, HVAC systems are not considered the primary level of protection. Similar to those laboratories, during a pandemic, we need the users of our buildings to utilize best practices for reducing the risks of virus transmission as their first layer of protection. Staying home if you are sick, performing daily attestations and health checks, washing or sanitizing your hands regularly, maintaining a distance of 6 feet or more from other people, and not touching faces are the primary and most important protections that we can provide for ourselves and our community as we interact in school buildings. The second layer of protection in laboratories is PPE, or personal protective equipment. In the case of COVID-19 risk minimization at schools, our PPE consists of all building occupants wearing masks. The director of the CDC was quoted on September 16, 2020, stating that wearing masks may be more effective at protecting against COVID-19 than a vaccine. He also stated that masks are the most important public health tool that we have. We need to all take advantage of this tool and protect ourselves and our community by wearing masks while in public. The third and final layer of protection in a laboratory is the HVAC system. This is similar in schools. HVAC systems cannot prevent the spread of a virus from one person to another. However, with modifications, a building can have a better chance of minimizing the spread from one space to another. By evaluating and modifying our systems, we will improve the capabilities of this third layer of protection in our schools. The quote on this slide is very helpful for understanding what can be done with HVAC systems. A risk reduction strategy is different from a goal of achieving zero cases. There is no such thing as zero risk in anything we do, and certainly not during a pandemic. The most important thing to understand regarding HVAC systems and their role in a building is that they are not a primary means of infectious disease control. HVAC systems in schools and almost all other building types are designed to maintain comfort. The three things used to measure comfort within an HVAC conditioned space are temperature, humidity, and odor control. Understanding that airborne particles can be pulled into HVAC systems, we know that COVID-19 could very likely be spread through an HVAC system. ASHRAE, the American Society of Heating, Refrigerating, and Air Conditioning Engineers, states that it is probable for COVID-19 to be spread through HVAC systems, and steps should be taken to reduce that risk. However, as we move further into this presentation, you will understand that HVAC modifications can only reduce risk of transmission in one of the three ways that COVID-19 can be spread, and it is not possible to prevent person-to-person transmission with HVAC modifications. COVID-19 spreads in three ways. One, large droplets. This is the primary form of viral transmission for COVID-19, and HVAC systems can do very little to prevent this type of viral transmission, as large droplets rarely enter those systems. Two, on surfaces. HVAC modifications cannot prevent this type of viral transmission. However, the Renton School District is putting in place enhanced sanitation programs to minimize the risk of viral transmission through this method. Three, aerosols, or airborne particles. This is where HVAC systems have a role in minimizing viral transmission, and we will be discussing further what the Renton School District is doing to minimize risk through this method during this presentation. While HVAC can only minimize risk through airborne particles, best practices and PPE can reduce risk of viral transmission from all three of these methods of viral transmission. Modifications to school building HVAC systems that can minimize viral transmission include 1. Increasing the amount of outside air introduced to the building. This reduces the amount of viral particles in the HVAC system and lowers the amount of air that is being recirculated throughout the building. 2. Flush buildings nightly with outside air. This allows a larger amount of fresh air exchange during unoccupied periods of building use, additionally reducing viral particles. 3. Install MERV 13 air filters throughout the school district. While MERV 13 filters are not laboratory-grade air filters, they are expected to be 60 to 70% efficient at removing COVID-19-sized particles. Other risk reduction technologies have been reviewed and considered by the Renton School District, such as UV lighting and bipolar ionization. However, there is currently little data on the effectiveness of these systems killing the virus or the methods to install them in a manner that is safe for our students and staff. We will continue to monitor technologies such as these as we move forward. As stated earlier, maintaining a 6-foot minimum distance from others while in social situations is a helpful tool for minimizing risk of viral transmission through close-range contact. An additional benefit of social distancing is a lower occupancy rate in each classroom. If all students are remaining 6 feet apart, then we are limited on the number of students that can occupy one classroom. This allows for higher volume of ventilation per person in each space and creates a higher likelihood of removing aerosol viral particles from a space. Please keep in mind that HVAC systems remove aerosol viral particles only, and these modifications do not prevent close-range contact viral transmission. So what is an HVAC system? HVAC stands for heating, ventilation, and air conditioning. We stated earlier that these systems are designed to provide comfort by adjusting temperature, humidity, and odor control. They also maintain the air quality within the spaces of a building by bringing fresh air into a building, heating and cooling that air to adjust the temperature, and exhausting stale indoor air to the outside. In Renton School District buildings, HVAC systems also filter particulate out of the interior air. These particulates can include dust, bacteria, and viruses. The basic components of an HVAC system include 1. Filters, which remove particulate from the air passing through them. The filter's ability to remove particulate is determined by its minimum efficiency reporting value, or MERV rating. Typical school systems utilize a filter with a MERV rating of somewhere between MERV 8 and MERV 11. The Renton School District will be updating our filters to MERV 13 to further reduce risk and help capture airborne virus particles. The school district also follows manufacturer's guidelines for filter changes and regular maintenance of our systems. 2. Coils, which heat and cool the air as it passes over them. 3. Fans, which move air through the ductwork and spaces of a building. Some buildings and spaces utilize one HVAC system per room of a building. These are known as single-zone air handlers, and each system specifically controls the temperature and air quality in one room. Other buildings and spaces use larger systems that serve multiple rooms. These are known as multi-zone air handlers. These systems have many different devices spaced throughout the system that allow multiple levels of comfort to be provided through one large unit. As seen in this slide, single-zone air handlers utilize a fan to pull air from the room and the outside. Then they mix those two types of air through a filter and coil to provide appropriate temperatures and ventilation for the space being served. There are single-zone air handlers being used throughout all of the schools and facilities listed on this slide. Multi-zone air handlers utilize a fan to pull air from indoor spaces and the outside, very similar to a single-zone air handler. The difference is that they are removing air from multiple spaces to mix with outdoor air, then running that air through a filter and coil to provide appropriate temperatures and ventilation for the multiple spaces being served. The fact to keep in mind with multi-zone air handlers is that unfiltered air does not travel from one interior space to another. Air is being pulled through a negatively pressurized return duct and then sent through a filter before being reintroduced to other spaces within a building. There are multi-zone air handlers being used throughout all of the schools and facilities listed on this slide. The other HVAC system that is utilized in our school buildings is exhaust. Exhaust systems pull air from an indoor space and send it directly outside with no reintroduction elsewhere in the building. A primary place exhaust is used is within bathrooms. Exhaust runs continuously in bathrooms to remove foul odors, airborne bacteria, and airborne viruses that may be within the space. People often ask if opening windows and running 100% outside air in the HVAC system will prevent the spread of COVID-19 in a building. The answer is likely no. The building systems would not be able to provide an acceptable level of heating and cooling for the occupants. This would create a high level of thermal stress for building users, and it would do nothing to prevent the spread of the virus by surface or respiratory droplets. Additionally, providing outdoor air in a space does not prevent viral transmission. It only provides a potentially minimized risk. The Renton School District is committed to following the best available guidance from authoritative sources such as the CDC, the Washington State Department of Health, and ASHRAE. To that end, the Renton School District will reduce recirculation by increasing the rate of outside ventilation as much as is practical without negatively impacting thermal comfort. Dilute indoor air by running the HVAC systems during and after school, and provide MERV 13 filters for recirculated air where practical. It is possible that airborne COVID-19 particles can get into the HVAC system. However, if that situation occurs, the Renton School District is working to modify our building systems and minimize the risk of viral transmission through the systems. As much as we would like to, it is not possible to eliminate the risk of viral transmission through an HVAC system. However, person-to-person contact has been shown to provide a much more likely transmission path than aerosol particles through HVAC systems. As stated earlier, opening windows does not necessarily lower the rate of viral transmission in a building or space. Opening windows is helpful for buildings with no HVAC system and no other means of introducing outside air to the interior spaces. However, Renton School District buildings have HVAC systems in place, and opening windows can make spaces uncomfortable and reduce the ability of the HVAC system to circulate air through the space and filtration system effectively. As previously discussed, bathrooms utilize exhaust systems to remove air from within the space and provide a negative pressure to prevent air from moving to other spaces within a building. While viral particles can exist within a bathroom, they will not be spread beyond the bathroom through the ventilation system. To allow bathroom exhaust to perform appropriately, all bathroom windows should remain closed, assuring that air is exhausted in a contained manner. So, the bottom line is that it is up to all of us to prevent viral transmission. Source control and behavior are critical. 1. The best way to minimize transmission is source control. Stay home if you are sick or if you have been exposed to someone who is sick. 2. The second best way is behavior. Wear a mask, wash your hands frequently, and practice social distancing. 3. No building modification can eliminate the risk of COVID-19 transmission. 4. Renton School District will do everything practical to reduce risk to our community members. And 5. We need help to keep everyone safe. We are all in this together.